Good day, good people. Let's talk about it. Kelly Loeffler, she is the Georgia Senator and the co-owner of the WNBA team, Atlanta Dream. So she just came out recently with some comments and some statements about the Black Lives Matter movement and the whole politics around it, and that the WNBA should not dedicate its season to this political stance, right? So she penned a letter to the WNBA commissioner, that is Kathy Engelbert. So she just does not want to have politics involved in sports, because in Kelly's mind, and I could agree with it too, with sports, you want to kind of bring people together and not, you know, separate people. Okay, I understand that too. But we're in a climate within the last year or so, and even more, where things are just not looking good. It's just a racial divide. And I think you can't separate the two when it comes to sports, because you're still dealing with human beings, and your minds just don't turn off and on just because you see sports, right? So it just gotten to a place of no return. So And just let you guys know too, Kelly is a Republican U.S. Senator, right? So, and she's married to New York Stock Exchange Chairman and CEO is Jeffrey Sprecher, right? And they were just in the news not too long ago in the springtime, right when the coronavirus happened. The couple, they sold about $1.2 to $3.1 million. in stock, and this was about 27 companies that they had stock in, right? So they had a private meeting and they got nervous and they started selling off. So there was a lot of public outcry about that. So they were just in the news about that. So she has the nerve now to say about this whole Black Lives Matter movement, it shouldn't be in the WNBA, and she wants to take, she does not want that to happen. It almost reminds me a little bit about, if you guys remember, Donald Sterling of the Los Angeles Clippers. He was ousted by the NBA for his racial disparities of black people and just the whole plantation mindset, right? So a lot of racism involved in that. So, you know, it reminds me a little bit about that. I want to know what you guys are thinking as well too. And I know the Mystics and the Liberty, New York Liberty standouts is, was it Natasha Cloud and Laisha Clatterin. Hopefully I'm saying it right. They both came out, they were on CNN, and they want Kelly ousted as well too. Like, she has no right to be in the WNBA. She does not have a right to own a team. They don't want her to be a part of that. Even the WNBA Players Association, they're coming out and saying that she needs to be ousted. They want to have a meeting with Kathy, the NBA commissioner, to see if that is possible. So, and you know, this is going to be a whole big fire story coming soon. And, you know, definitely you guys keep an eye on that. And with Kelly, she was the owner. She took a minority ownership back in 2011 for the Atlanta Dream. And in 2018, she purchased the main, you know, the majority of the team. So she definitely has some say within the team and things like that. And to give you a little bit of background about Kelly, she's from the Illinois area, and you know, she was raised on a farm with soybeans and things like that, right, on a farm. And her parents got her into, she went to the University of Illinois, where she got her bachelor's degree, and then she got her MBA from DePaul University. And records show that she she claims, when she was on her campaign trail, on her ads and things like that, that the way she got into graduate school, that she waited tables, and that's actually not correct. So it's just to show you a lot of deception and lies that she already has been telling, even through her past and currently, right? So the way she got into school, she actually mortgaged the land that her grandparents gave her. She inherited land and she mortgaged the land to get into graduate school. So she did not wait tables to get, you know, to get into grad school. And another thing that I wanted to let you guys know too, She actually married, you know, her current husband back in 2004, Jeffrey Sprecher. He was actually CEO of a company and that she worked for back in 2002, and she married up. And then she was promoted to senior vice president, things like that. So you could kind of see how she gets in where she fits in, if you know what I mean. So very wealthy couple. They own over a $10 million home in Atlanta suburbs. And yeah, about 15,000 square feet, $10 million. So worth a lot of money. But at the end of the day, she went on Fox as well too. And she did say that she is not going to sell the team. She's not going to leave the WNBA. But again, it reminds me a lot of Donald Sterling. If you know, it really, really does. The first, when I heard about it, was it last week about this story? I was thinking Donald Sterling right away. And if you feel a certain way, you got to keep that to yourself. You know, by penning a letter to Kathy Engelbert, the commissioner, to say, hey, let's not do this whole Black Lives Matter movement. Let's not dedicate this, you know, for the players. And 80% of the WNBA guys, if you didn't know, are black people, right? Black women. So I don't know, it was just a little disturbing. It didn't surprise me or shock me. It just shows you a lot about her, and I did a lot of research on her. And yeah, she's definitely a manipulator, and she's very deceptive. And yeah, but the whole with the stocks and everything like that didn't surprise me as well either, because you know, there are a lot of rich people that do that, worth a lot of money. They, you know, they heard about the pandemic, they got nervous and then started selling off. And you know, it's easy for someone that with that kind of net worth to sell off over $1 to $3 million in stock. And that's what she did, her and her husband did. And they are being investigated on that right as we speak. So I want to know what you guys are thinking. Please comment, tell me what you think about Kelly Loeffler. Again, she is the Georgia senator. And she, you know, again, she's from Chicago, not Chicago, she's from Illinois, and she co-owns the Atlanta Dream WNBA team. Do you want to see her out the league? What are you guys thinking? Let me know. Support the channel. Thank you again, and subscribe, and talk to you guys soon. Peace and love.